So I want everyone's eyes on the board now in 3, 2, and 1. We're continuing our topic areas of a combination of plane figures. And this is example number 5, a very, very easy question. They're asking us to find a shaded region, find this blue region. Yeah, that's what they're asking us to do. Anyone has a thought here? Yes. Yes. The circles are all equal, yes. Okay. To find one circle's area, what do you need? You need? Huh? You're saying the side is 14 centimeters, so you make it half because there are two circles. So what do you get as diameter of one circle? 7. So what will the radius be? 7.2, or you can just take pi d square by 4 also, all right? Basically, it's area of shaded region. Can you tell me what will I write equal to? Yes, Manisha, go ahead. Area of square ABCD minus 4 into area of one circle. Is that okay? And for this area of one circle, you will need the diameter, that is a diameter of circle is equal to 14 by 2. Okay. Be good with that. That's equal to 7 centimeter. So area of one circle will be pi d square by 4. You put 14 here. What will you take pi now, Nischay? What should you take pi now? No, Nishay. This is a multiple of 7. So your 7 will get cancelled off when you take 22 by 7. Okay. An area of square will be 14 into 14. Okay with that? You'll all be able to calculate this. Do I need to do it on board? Is that you have a doubt? Go ahead. So, yes, Riza is asking, do we need to give reasons of why we are taking that? Why, how diameter came 7 and how... what is happening here? Okay, like, why did we take diameter of 7? Even in the question, they have not given a clear explanation that, you know, this is half the circle. This is like exactly half the diameter, half the side of the circle. The diameter is half the side of the square that they have not given. But it's what we are assuming by looking at the circle. Yeah. Now, we in this exercise, in the example questions which are done in the textbook also, there is no reasoning given as to why they are taking this diameter as 7. Okay. So if the example is not giving, we can clearly follow the method which is being used in the textbook. So we don't have to get into the reasonings. Okay. A lot of reasonings you don't have to get into. Just like in yesterday's thing, you don't have to get into the reasoning of why these four triangles are congruent. Okay. It's a knowledge which we have already established earlier. We are using that knowledge. Okay. Good with that, Riza? But if you feel that it's not, you don't feel satisfied while writing the answer, and you feel you have the time, write down the reason. Okay. As far as possible, write it down. Okay. We have built that habit already, so we'll write it down. Okay. But it's not an ask, as far as I can understand from the example questions. All right. Good with that, everyone? Yes. All right, guys. Can I have your attention back? Some disturbance? Now this question, example 6, okay, it's a very interesting question. It is actually one of a slightly tougher type of questions in this chapter, okay? And see, forget about this. This diagram is not given. This diagram they have drawn after while solving, okay? Let's look at this question. They're saying find the area of the shaded design in this figure where ABCD is a square of side 10 centimeters. They've given this is a square, okay? And semicircles are drawn on each side of the square, which means this is a semicircle, this is a semicircle, this is a semicircle, and this is a semicircle. You get how this shape is made now? All right, I'm going to give you guys, close your textbooks, I'm going to give you guys 3 minutes to discuss amongst yourselves or to think about it and tell me how you're going to find this area. All right, this is a tricky one, time to think, get started. It's great to see 6 people having spent so much time and cracked it actually. So we are going to get into and explain it together, what every one of you has said. So the idea is at the end of the, I want you also to follow my thought process here, okay? At the end, for the final answer, that's this four shaded region, what do I need? I need square area minus this white area, these four white area, correct? Square area is simple, but can I get the white areas? There is not even a figure which we know, right? Not circle, not a triangle, not a quadrilateral which we know, yeah? So we have to find out a way of finding this area. We have to find out a way of finding this area. If we find this area, we can easily get these four areas. They're all going to be the same because all circles are, all semicircles are same and all, and it's, all right? So we'll find out this one green area and multiply it by four, or finally, you know, find out these four green areas and subtract it from this square. That's the thought process here, okay? To do that, now your question has become different, okay? Now let me put it this way. Let's write this down, okay? So that's what they're doing here. What they're doing is, in this solution, they are saying area shaded is equal to area of square ABCD minus sum of areas 1, 2, 3, and 4. Is that okay? That is 1, 2, 3, and 4 is these regions. Okay with that? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now stay with me here. Now our question has changed. For us, the problem is not this anymore. The problem is not this anymore because we know this. The problem has become this. How do we find sum of areas 1, 2, 3, and 4? Okay. Now for that, you start thinking, take it one step at a time. Okay. Now you see this one, if I were to only take one, it will be like, okay, now that's a little difficult thing. So we are taking the whole thing together. And if I take two of these semicircles, I take these two semicircles out of the square, I'm left with 1 and 3. Yeah, I'm left with 1 and 3. Good with that? The same goes for the other thing. That is, if I take these two semicircles out of the square, that's if I take this red part out and this red part out, I'm left with what? 2 and 4. Yeah. So you know how to find sum of areas 1, 2, 3, and 4. We know how to do that. We'll have to obviously do 1 and 3 together and then 2 and 4 together, right? And then we will get the sum by adding those two. And then we'll subtract it from the square of area ABCD. Square ABCD. Yeah. How are you feeling about this now? 55, please. Abhi, where are you? Okay, on the board. Yeah. So we are starting. So area of, so this is a diagram. This diagram is a part of the solution. Okay. This is what you are doing. Okay. You are marking this 1, 2, 3, and 4. Got it? All right. So it becomes area of 2 and 3. Area of 1 and 3 is equal to area of square minus square ABCD minus area of semicircle. Area of two semicircles. Can I say that? Oh, one second. System is stuck. Area of semicircle into two. Yeah. Everyone okay with this? Can you quickly tell me what will be the radius of the semicircle? Radius of each semicircle, or you can say diameter of each semicircle. Radius of each semicircle will be what? MG? My side length is 10. So this is fully 10. So my radius will also be 10 divided by 2. Diameter will be 10, radius will be 10 by 2. Yeah, it's equal to 5 centimeter. Yeah. So this area of semicircle into 2, that is semicircle ka area is how much? Formula of area of semicircle is how much? Sri Priya? Area of semicircle, how will you write? Circle formula we know. What is area of semicircle? Hemanji?
Half
into pi r square. Half of the circle, no. Into 2 you have to do. Basically, it becomes finally area of one circle only because two semicircles when you add, it becomes a circle. Sri Priya is not paying attention right now. Area of square ABCD is what? 10 into 10. Yeah. Minus this thing. that's equal to 10 into 10 minus 3.14 into 5 into 5. Okay, you do this, you get area of 2, 1 and 3. Okay with that? Your answer will come to 21.5 centimeter square. Okay, not doing the calculation. Next is area of 3 and 4. Area of 2 and 4. Similarly, can I write similarly? Because the same logic is being used, right? You are subtracting the area of the whole square minus these two semicircles. So area of square ABCD minus area of two semicircles, that's equal to 21.5 centimeter square. Okay with that so far? Similarly, you're saying yes, it is enough because the logic is very clear. There is no ambiguity in the question. So it's very, very clear that all these semicircles are the same diameter. So you can write that down. Since all circles have the same diameter, you know, similarly when you're writing, you can write, since all the semicircles have the same diameter, you can write that here, okay? Otherwise, if you don't write that also, in this particular chapter, it is acceptable because the goal is to find the final area, okay? So that will give you this, and then you come back to the first equation. You will add 21.5 and 21.5, you will get 43. That's this part, sum of the areas 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is what, 100 minus 43, that's equal to 57 centimeters square. Okay, obviously not here, at the end you will write. Good with that? We can all do this. How are we feeling? 55, please here.